and go.
Hey, welcome to Area 51 Raceway. We are here today to talk about painting. I'm just kind of like going through a few things I could revisit. I've done a lot of, well, not a lot, but I've done a couple of painting videos through the channel. And, you know, people will ask, you know, what? How should I start? Is rattle can okay? Can I, you know, do I need to get an airbrush? Do I need to get involved in airbrushing? It's all about your comfort level. There's a lot of people that paint with spray cans and they do spectacularly good work. Nothing wrong with the spray can. And there are people that want to do airbrushing and airbrushing is just as good. So it's just your comfort level, what you want to attack first. What I would recommend is trying the rattle can method first because that'll get you into the door to start because you don't need all this equipment as you would with airbrushing, which is the compressor, the airbrush itself, and so on. So with a rattle can, it's a little easy. You could still do it outside as long as you get it kind of in a dust-free area, though it is a little tough. But I've done it outside where you know, hold it on a, with these right here from Tamiya, the painting stands, and then you spray it out in the open. But just remember, just try and keep it in a, don't do it on a windy day or there's a dust cloud because it will go on the paint. But there's a way to do it with a rattle can. Now, how I prep all my cars, if it's hard plastic, I do not sand it down or nothing, because when you put sanding marks into a surface, that's going to come out when you paint it. So you get it comes out, it'll come out what you do to it prior before anything. So with a hard plastic body, I will wash it really good with soap and water, and then I'll hit it with alcohol, kind of wipe it clean. Or what you could do also is use a tack cloth before you paint it as well. And a tack cloth are these, and these are sticky cloths that will remove dust or anything that's on the paint. And when you take these out, when you open them up, let them gas out for 15 minutes, and then you could use them to pre-wipe the body to make sure you get all the dust and stuff off. Now, after I wash it and clean it and, you know, prep it, I use this stuff right here. So this is Rust-Oleum Automotive Primer 2-in-1 filler and sandable primer. This is excellent stuff. I've used this all the time. It was recommended to me by Mark Thomas. Mark Thomas really knows how to paint bodies, and I usually would pick his brain about it and what to use and stuff, which I've done in the past. And it's great primer. I wouldn't use anything else myself personally, but there are other primers as well. As long as you're putting a primer, that's real important. But this is good for resin bodies and hard plastic bodies, and I've used them on both. So this is my go-to primer that I use, and what I'll initially do is clean the body, you know, wipe it down with a tack cloth, and then spray it. And this dries pretty quick, about 15-20 minutes will be dried. And away we go from there after that. Now, I like Rust-Oleum products. I know there's other stuff as well as far as spray can goes, but I do like the Rust-Oleum 2X product because it really lays on nicely and it does really well. I've used this on quite a few cars. I've used it on the black 55 Chevy that I took to the Summerfest, which is this one right here with the broken bumper that I did the challenge with. And it's just a simple black paint job, but it looks fine. I mean, I probably could do a little bit better if I would have glossed this more, but I didn't. I just shot the black, and that's the end result. It's a decent looking car. It does the job. And I have other examples of painting with that paint, and I will show you. So I have another car, a land barge that I've done, in also just a spray can form. And here's an example of that. This is a apple red. As you can see, that's a really nice finish. And this is a rattle can. I didn't do an airbrush on this. This is what you could achieve with a rattle can. So if you start out simple with just one color, just to, you know, to get yourself, you know, your foot into the door, that's the best way to do it. And then later on, you could start, you know, striping and stuff, which is a little bit more advanced, but you will find other people with other videos that have done it. And of course, Dave, who's really good with paint, you could also ask him for his advice because he's good with doing a lot of those things as well. I only may have done it one or twice, but I haven't ventured it a little bit more, which I will. But Again, this is a rattle can. This is what you could achieve with a rattle can. And this is what I use, the 2X paints. Really good paint. I didn't need to clear that one. That was just the paint itself. No clearing of this. Now, let's talk about water-based acrylic paints. I use specifically the Createx paints. There are a lot of companies out there, and there are a ton of just different acrylics and, you know, and lacquer paint companies out there. I would recommend checking out Barbatos Rex YouTube channel. He has reviewed every paint that I've ever seen on this channel, and it's a real good channel if you want to check up, like, you know, look up certain paints that he's testing, because he's tested every one of them. He's always testing stuff as it comes out as well. He's really good at, you know, explaining stuff to you and, you know, how it reacts and paints it right on camera. It's a great channel, so I highly recommend it. Now, I use Createx paints because I like them, because they're easy to use. They're pretty forgiving, in my opinion. I haven't used anything else, to be honest. So I'm not a representative of Createx. I don't get paid by anybody because I'm saying Createx. I just like the color of the paints, and I like how they perform. Now, examples here of these cars. Again, I use the Rust-Oleum as a primer. Now, you have to remember with acrylic paints, since they are water-based paints, you have to remember that when you use acrylic water-based paints, you cannot wet sand the body. The water will break down the paint. So basically you dry sand them. It's not like lacquer. So it's highly recommended, do not use any water or anything on these paints when you paint a body, or you're going to be in for a severe shock, because you're going to take your paint off, and then you'll have to start all over again, which I have done before on accident, because again, this is trial by fire. You learn as you go. I remember I had to strip a body. It's one thing nice about acrylic is that you could strip it pretty quick and then start over again if something happens. That I've done that with one of the cars. I had to strip it like 4 times. And again, you learn as you go. It gets frustrating, but I kind of now have my kind of system on how I do stuff and how I see what works for me. Now, for example, here is the Createx Blood Red. And what I have with this color is underneath is the pearlized gold. So this is pearl gold. So this is the base to create this color. And then what you do is you use a candy, which this is blood red. And that's how you shoot this to get a candy apple red, because it's a gold-based color. Here's an example of the midget I've been building, which I recently did. And that's what this looks like. It's just basically a gold pearl underneath, and then a red candy, blood red candy over it, and you're spraying it lightly to get this color, because you slightly build this up. And what I'll do is I'll show you on camera how I primer these bodies and how I paint them. I think I need to revisit this, because, you know, a lot of people get a little intimidated by paint. I was intimidated by painting with airbrush, because I sucked it when I first did it, and it was frustrating, and I was using really shitty airbrushes. Quality of the airbrush is real important too. That's my opinion on that. If you can make a cheap airbrush, wear it, cool. But the one I use for large model bodies and 1/32 is this Pro Convoy one. This is a Krios, excuse me. This is a Krios Pro Convoy, and this is a 0.5 needle. And what I like about this airbrush in particular is that it's not very expensive. Though I could be wrong, because everything has been increasing in price. This could be under $100, could be a little over 100, I can't remember. But I like how it has this fanning tip, because this reminds me of an automotive fanning tip. And this is what I like about this. And it's a really easy gun to clean. There's parts readily available for it if something, you know, breaks on it, which that happened one time. I had to order parts for it. And then it's got a cup, gravity-fed cup, not a siphoning one, and it goes on here. Easy to clean, take apart. There's instructions on how to take it apart. And pretty self-explanatory. But this is an excellent gun that works well with these paints. Now, mixing the paint is another thing as well. And they will tell you on the bottle here what to mix it with. So it's this is a mix with 40-30 or 40-50. So this candy, I use 40-50 gloss. And what I do is I do it by eyeball. I don't I just pour how much do I need in a little cup and then pour this and then mix it, and I get a consistency to where it's thin enough that the brush is, the airbrush is going to push it through. You don't want it too thick. So you want to be able to thin it out perfectly. And I'll do that on camera because I do it by eyeball. I don't do it by measurement because this is such tiny amounts. I'm not painting an actual large vehicle. So I use kind of like eyeball amounts, and then I kind of judge it as it comes out of the gun as I test it, spraying my piece of wood or whatever I have there. Now, after you've painted and stuff, this is another important thing, which I'm going to go over this one right here, this acrylic clear. So here's an example. So I painted this. And this is all done. I got it all painted, it dried. And what I did was I shot it with this clear. This is a Krylon clear, which works well. Rust-Oleum work well too. This one works pretty good, that's why I have it. And what I do is after I paint the initial, color, base colors that I use this and clear it to protect it. So now that I have a clear on this, I can now apply decals. Now, this is a sticker decals, and what I mean decals is I mean water slides. Once you have a clear on here, two coats of clear, and you let it dry an amount of time it tells you to, you could get your water slides and put them on here, and it will not bleed the paint out. Excuse me, paint out. It won't make it, the water will not affect it because you have a clear coating on it. And that's really important because if you try and put water slide decals and have not cleared it with acrylic, it's going to run the paint and then it's going to break it down and you're going to be pretty upset about it because then you have to start all over again. So this is what I do with water slide decals. And then after I place my water slide decals, which I've done with this car, I will clear it again with this after the water slides are on. And the reason why I do that is because I like to use the Rust-Oleum 2X gloss, and this is lacquer, so this is going to heat up more. What happens is when you spray this paint and it heats up, it's hotter, it's going to make these decals like shrivel up and then look like they're wilting flowers, and you don't want to do that. So what I do is after I clear it, after I paint it, and then I clear it, and then I put my water slides, and then I clear it again with acrylic clear and let it dry this way to protect the decals, and then I'll spray it with a gloss and I'll get my glossy finish. Or you could even stick with this if you want. If you're happy enough with just how it came out, that's fine, because this is just with acrylic clear and it looks pretty good. But it's up to you how you want to do it. That's mainly how I go about, decaling bodies and then painting them afterwards. Now we're gonna go over to the shed, which is in the backyard, and I have a little paint booth set up with an air compressor. I'm gonna show you how I paint the body initially and kind of go from there, all right? So come join me. Hey, welcome to the Area 51 Hangar 1 paint booth. This is a shed out in the backyard of my home. It's got a lot of room than the old house. The old shed was a little smaller. This one's actually got a lot of things. It came with lights, this tape, this bench here, and this cabinet, which is pretty cool because I could put my paints in here and whatnot. And I have my paint booth here. So this paint booth I got from Amazon, it's basically one that collapses and folds up. I've used it quite a bit, works well. Probably need to clean the filter, which I'll do later. But what I'm going to do now is we're going to primer the bodies. Now I'm going to do two bodies. They're going to be resin bodies. One I painted before. I cleaned that up. It looks like a terrible paint job because I didn't like the scheme of it. I'm going to paint over it with Rust-Oleum. And that one I'm going to use regular old rattle cam paint. And then the other one I'm going to use an airbrush. So you can see the differences and stuff and kind of get where you want to be at. And maybe later on you want to do airbrush, you can. But if you want to do rattle cam, this is how simple it is. You can do rattle cam and you can also mask and all that stuff. It's not that hard. And I'm running out of this primer, which I need to get more. So I'm going to rattle this up really good. I'm going to turn on my booth. And we're going to get painting. All right, here we go. I'm going to clean it with my Gerson tack cloth. Just kind of wipe it down, get any dust off of it. Of course, this body's moving around because it's not real tight on the stand, but that's no big deal. I have a plastic glove on here. I'm just going to wipe this down. And I should have tensioned that more, and I didn't. Moving around a lot. And I'm going to get my other body. Clean it with the tack cloth. All this does is remove dust, almost dropped it, and cleans the dust off the car. If there's any sticky dust around, this is a tack cloth, very tacky. So you could start painting right away, ain't going to do anything to, you know, the surface of the car. So what we're going to do is now we're done mixing this, we're going to primer the first body, and of course, nice sweeps like that. One coat there, start out light. See, you got some on that one, but no big deal because we're priming all these cars here. So if it gets on any of them, don't matter. It's the same type of primer we're using. All right, one coat. This stuff dries pretty quick, like I said. Let it dry a little. And we could go over this again real quick. Always get the bottom rocker panel. That seems to be missed. That's why I kind of tilt this like that. And gotta hate that thing's not holding it on that well. I'll probably adjust that when I'm done priming it. And we'll go over this car. That, and we'll move on to the next one. As you can see, we got some stuff there that we could sand away. See some stuff got on there. That's no big deal. It is a little, that filter, I need to change it. I have it. So that could be easily corrected by just, you know, sanding it just very lightly. It's ain't going to need much. I mean, I could probably just scrape it off too. But, there we go. That's pretty much primered right there. Gotta hate that thing's tipping like that. We'll leave that alone. We'll go to the next car. Make sure this one's primed pretty good because it had paint underneath it. Now I had scuffed that other paint a little bit with Scotch-Brite just to, you know, get a little roughness from it. God, I'm running out of this paint. That sucks. There we go. That's just, you know, a quick primer job. Now we got both cars primered. We'll let them dry. We'll check them out after we're done. And we could do a little, you know, a little sanding on them. You see that right there and get them nice and smooth and ready for paint. Okay, I got the body checked out. It looks smooth, good enough. What I'm going to do is use a rattle can. This is Metallic Gold 2X. And we're just going to spray it away. See, this paint really lies on nicely is what I like about it. Very subtle sweeps and it covers a lot. And I do love the nozzles on these compared to the Krylon nozzles. Of course, get underneath there and underneath here. Got yourself a gold Camaro. I think Harry would approve of that. Put some black in there and it'll have his favorite colors. But there you go. Let that dry, and in between coats, on this one right here, you can wait 5 minutes. It doesn't take, you could go in between coats pretty quickly with this stuff. It's really great paint. I prefer to use it if I rattle can this stuff. Now, there may be other stuff as well. Obviously, Duplicolor is more expensive because those are actual car colors, but you can use that as well. And it's up to you what spray paint you want to use. If you find a color you like, go for it. Just read the can instructions and make sure your bases are covered. You got good primer on it and it's nice and smooth. This way it'll come out good when you paint it. Quick, going back to the spray can deal, you can see that looks pretty good, and I can put numbers on this. I'll put acrylic clear and then shoot this with gloss and it should come out fine. And you can see this little, not super smooth, but it's pretty good. And I didn't do much to this. I did very little. I should have did a little bit more like I did on that one, but hey, you know, this is just for, I'm showing how a beginner would do it if you were to just, you know, wipe it down and just shoot again. And of course you can wet sand this, but you have to let this dry for a couple of days. You don't want to put resin bodies in a dehydrator, which I've been known to do, but I do those with hard plastic models because this will distort because it's resin and the heat will make it warp and then you'll have a big problem. So let this sit for, you know, say like 2 or 3 days, and then you can wet sand it and then you can shoot it again if you want it more smoother. But again, this is just showing that rattle can is good enough. That looks really cool. I could go ahead and put decals on this, and then what I could do is I could paint this, you know, acrylic and then put a gloss and it'll look really nice. So there you go for that model right there. This is a spray can basically. Okay, so I am moving on to the resin body with acrylic paint. Now after painting this, I used 5,000 grit. This is what this is, 5,000 grit sandpaper. To smooth this out, and I didn't need anything super rough because there'll be little bumps. I just say little bumps from the primer, and that could be really swept off with your hand. But then also I used the 5,000 and then soapy, you know, water. Basically I used soapy water, but water, and scrubbed it down, and it looks fairly really nice. And that's good enough for me because of course when I paint this, it will look a little better than, you know, it shouldn't show any of this at all because it's pretty much smoothed out. Hope you can see that on camera, but that's pretty in essence ready to go. And then what I usually do is I wipe it down with alcohol, one wipe of alcohol, and this car is prepped and ready to go. Now, we're going to go on to mixing paints. So what I've decided to use for the first part of it was called a silver sealer. And this is reduced with 411, as it says right here, reduce 10% by volume. And again, got to remember, this is, how would you say, all by sight, by how it looks. It's not, how would you say, so I'm shaking this up. I want to shake this up real good, by the way, because this has got like, you know, silver, and you can hear the ball moving around. And they do recommend you shake these up real good. And then what I'm going to do is, I've opened this before. I'm going to just basically just guess what I'm going to use. I'm going to say about that much. See, and then I'm going to get my reducer and thin it out. Just like that. And then I'm going to stir it. Just like that. Give it a little stir. Make sure you don't flick it all over the place like I'm doing there, because, shoot, my wife's going to kill me. Oh, it's going on my shirt, so I should have worn a different shirt. You see as I'm mixing it up. So, say you want it like a milky, but it's, like I said, again, I'm going by sight. And, you know, I do this all the time. I don't, you know, I'm not a painting expert. And, shoot, you want to be able to mix this up. That's why the bottom of these containers have the little tabs, and they flick your cup, your stuff around. It's better to get the ones that are, that have no tabs on the bottom of it. So I'm going to mix it up. Should have a popsicle stick, would be better to gauge this, but I'm going to go with that. Like I said, I could adjust this with the gun. I'm not a painting expert, like I told everybody. And I think that's pretty good right there. And what's nice about this stuff, it's water-based, so you don't have to worry about, you know, doing that. Oh, one thing I forgot to do, my goodness. Add a little gloss. That's my bad there. Shake that up. Forgot to add the gloss, which I usually do. And, yeah, a little bit right there. And that's why it seemed a little bit thick, too. There we go. I'm going to mix that in. Again, this is all a sight thing. I don't really, it's not like I'm painting a large car, so I can't really like go, oh, I'm going to go, you know, so many ounces of this, so many ounces of that. I guess you could if you wanted to, but this is such a little amount. I go by how the paint looks and how it sprays out of the gun. Yeah, that's pretty good. And then with this stuff, you have to let it set for 10 to 15 minutes, they recommend, because what's going to happen is this stuff, I'll shake this up, it's going to work together. How would you say it's going to mix together and needs time to react? So the 40-50 gloss with the, you know, with the sealer needs to kind of gather, how would you say, or mix, work together, have its little reaction. So we'll let that sit for 10 minutes. This is going to be our base right there, is that. And then we're going to use what's called poison green is this color. So we're going to use this, and this is a candy, and we're going to use this, and you're going to see how I use, you know, a real low amount of pressure and kind of lightly put this on. So we'll let that sit, and we'll go back to the booth, and we'll shoot the first base coat of this silver sealer on this model. All right, we got the paint loaded into the gun. This is an airbrush we're going to be using. And let me get a glove on so I don't spill it all over, or actually get paint on my hand actually when I'm spraying this. So I'm using a plastic vinyl glove right here. Sound like I'm the lunch lady here. And I'm going to grab my paint. And I got my body all set to go. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to spray it. Just a little bit different from what we traditionally do with a spray, you know, can. It doesn't look like it's going on, but it is. It's got this sparkly to it. I don't know if you could see it. And again, it just takes a little time. You just got to have more patience with the air gun, the airbrush, excuse me. And you can see it's getting silver. just hard to tell right now, but it is. Little by little. There's a technique you can do, it's called flash drying. So I'm not putting paint on it, but I'm using air to dry the paint, which some guys have used this technique. And then you could resume painting if you want. I just like how this brush, this airbrush lays the paint out, because it's got a nice nozzle on it, a 0.05 nozzle. And that's my... see that? Hey, damn bug. See, we had an invader land on got off right away, though. Good thing I didn't spray him on the car. There you go. Nothing scripted here. Shit like that happens here at Area 51. All right, we got our poison green loaded, and we're going to do just a quick light coats on this to give it the color we want to tint it. Let's see, just gradually lay it on. It will start changing color, trust me. Doesn't look like it is, but it will. It's going to go light. Oh, and be careful that you don't tilt this. Yeah, I tilted that, so we'll keep our body like this so I don't tilt this, because that'll come right out. Nice light layers. Like that. See, we're getting the green color on there. I mean, if you want to go light like that, you could go light, or if you want to go darker, you go darker. I'm going to go darker because I kind of want a dark green. And you see, I'm making it darker. And it will change if you put more on there. See how that changes right there? I'm just putting it on heavier. One special to me, what you think, guys? And then we could do a little, you know, flash drying, as they call it, by just using the air to flash dry it. Just a little. I'll let it sit there because I don't want to splotch it, because if you get too close, this will splotch and it'll look terrible, which has happened to me before. So, not too bad. And we'll leave it at that, and maybe I'll add some more color and we'll go back over to, you know, the bench and check it out. All right, here we are back. We are at the bench. There you go. That goes to show you can do it any way you want to. So if you want to do rattle can, or if you want to do airbrush, there's your results. Still the same. You could do either way what you want to do. Again, like I said, nothing wrong with rattle can. So what I done with this one right here, this Camaro, all I did was shoot it with two light coats of clear. You can see how it looks. I could probably go more and get it more shinier. And then with the Createx water acrylic paint, I use some clear acrylic, and I could go a little bit deeper than that. You could leave it like that and just use this if you want. You don't have to clear it with a lacquer clear. That's totally up to you. But now with this one, I could apply my decals, because now I put a clear on it, and I don't have to worry about it ruining the paint, because the paint is water-based. And this, once it hardens, it won't react to water, so it should be fine. So you'd be safe to put your water slides on and then coat them again with this. After that, if you want to put lacquer clear, you can, if you want more shine, or just stick with this or whatever you use. And of course, with this one, you can put your water slides, and then I would use this if you're using water slides or stickers or whatever, and then coat it with this again, because you can do that. So this way you could keep the this will protect the decals from curling up, because this gets hotter, obviously. So when you put water slides on this, coat it with the acrylic clear, like two light coats, and then go back with this and then clear it again, and you'll get the same results. But hey, this is what everything looks like. Not too shabby. I think it came out real good. Like I said, that silver sealers are real super, how would you say, bits of silver in it. So it's pretty metallic. And then I used a what's called poison green of candy, and that's my result. Now, if you use a gold base or a black, it would change the tones of this, and you could experiment with that on a spoon or something if you want to see what you want to get. But you could, again, you could see both these cars. They look really good. That gold one actually turned out pretty good for something I just wanted to throw together. So I didn't like the crappy paint job I put in it originally. It was that yellow and black that looked terrible how I did it. And also I could detail the nose like I did on that other paint, which just mask it and paint that black if I wanted to, which I could do that because you could see the lines where I left it there. But again, you know, it's not really hard to do. And also it's your choice. You know, there's nothing wrong with the rattle can. And of course, if you want to advance yourself, there's nothing wrong with the airbrush. This is a good airbrush. Take your pick. Now, obviously, if you get an airbrush, there's more in-depth things you need to know about it. Like when you're putting paints in here, you have to filter them because you could clog the nozzle with those bits there. And I didn't put that in the video, but I'm letting you know now. If you do use airbrush, always filter your paints, especially metallics and candies and all that, because junk will get in that nozzle and clog it up, and you'll be not having any paint come out. So that's just a forewarning to that. But again, if you go rattle can, this gold Camaro looks really cool. I could probably shoot another clear on that. I think it looks really shiny, but it looks pretty good right now. So again, I hope this little painting thing, I know it was a little long, helps you out and kind of gets you in the door to not to be so shy that your Aerosol, the rattle can, is just as good as airbrush, and you could do it either way. It's totally up to you. So that's it for this segment here. As always, thank you for watching, and take care and have fun racing. Yeah!